What is up, guys? Welcome back to the channel. And last week I lost the role on a CTS to an undead warrior in my guild, and so I wanted to kind of take a step back from thinking towards getting some of the BIS weapons and seeing how you can perform in some of the off-spec items. So with that, I also wanted to pose the question, how good are some of these off-spec pieces? How reliant are we on exactly having these BIS weapons? And also, if people are making this excuse of, oh, I can't do nearly as much DPS as you because you have these weapons and I have these weapons, is that really a valid excuse? So this is the first of multiple videos where I'm going to try out different quote-unquote meme specs or meme weapons where I go into the raid in a very good guild and I try to see if I can be the number one rogue DPS in my raid or even possibly the number one DPS in my raid entirely. So today, to start things off, we're going to ask ourselves, how good is the Claw of the Black Drake? And can you perform at the highest level with this weapon? Of course, if you like this sort of video, make sure to like and subscribe, or come hang out with me on Twitch. My name is Sarth, and let's get right into it. No matter what, weapons are the biggest DPS increase throughout the entire game for any gear piece for a rogue, and I think that's pretty consistent for most melee. But even if you don't have the best weapons in the game, you can actually perform extremely well. You can get 99s with Claw of the Black Drake. You can get 99s with Viscag. There's a lot of rogues on our server, and you probably see them on your server in the top 5 rogues on your entire server actually using Viscag and maybe even Brute Blade still. And when you see something like that, you have to ask yourself, are you allowing weapons to be a crutch for your own performance, or is it actually going to make that big of a difference when you do get this new weapon? Okay, so first things first, I wanted to break down some of the exact numbers of some of these weapons. So I reopened and actually adjusted some of the numbers with the new sims of the actual weapons for pretty much every weapon in the game for rogues, from your main hand to your offhand. So moving on from swords to daggers to combinations, and then also your BIS list per phase. But today we're talking about combinations, offset pieces, or really comparing kind of the items that aren't the conventional BIS. Because in Naxx, a lot of weapons, like multiple swords or maces, are incredibly good, and they're not the KT weapons. So you might not have to just go after those. And we're gonna kind of break down why. So the best weapons currently in the game, by far, are Deathsting and Blessed Karaji Pujo. If you're dual wielding these, this is the strongest setup for any rogue right now, and it is just so powerful, mainly because Deathsting is so much more powerful than any other item in the game. Although I will pose this caveat that it is a lot easier to perform really well as swords, so with AQR Maladath, if you're non-human, you are going to crush the raid, generally, possibly better than your dagger rogues unless your guild is extremely clean. And if you want to see a video breaking down why swords versus daggers is a thing, I'll just link one right up in one of those sides. So Deathsting and Pujo will put you in phase 5 BIS almost at 1600 DPS. AQR and Maladath, the quote-unquote BIS swords, will put you at 1540 DPS. Then I wanted to ask, how good is Claw of the Black Drake? So scrolling down, Claw of the Black Drake and Thunder Fury is actually a pretty decent setup, but most people don't have that. So Claw of the Black Drake and Blessed Karaji Pujo is your next best setup, but again, if you have the Pujo, you're probably daggers and doing more DPS that way. So then what are we going to actually look at? And that's Claw of the Black Drake and the Dagger of Veiled Shadows set. This is going to be your offhand set. It is about 10 DPS stronger than using Claw of the Black Drake and Corehound Tooth because the Veiled Shadows set is so powerful. One, the dagger itself is better than Corehound Tooth as an offhand, but you also get that reduction to your slice and dice. Now, if we compare Claw of the Black Drake and the Veiled Shadows set to something like CTS and Maladath, you are taking about a 47 DPS decrease, but Is that enough to actually set you back in the entire raid? Are you gonna let that hinder you? I am personally lucky enough to have Thunder Fury, so Claw of the Black Drake and Thunder Fury actually comes out to be about 17, almost 18 DPS less than AQR and Maladath, which is something that a lot of rogues in my raid are actually running. So when going into this raid, I was at a DPS disadvantage, of course, but am I gonna let that dictate how much damage I do, or am I going to try to outplay them as a whole? So with that question, let's move right on. So we were running AQ split last week, and it was actually not the cleanest of runs. It took about an hour, but it wasn't the cleanest of runs. But in that run, if I scroll down on damage done, I actually did the most damage in the entire raid to bosses. And then if we go to all encounters and trash, I was slightly below the number one warrior by about 17 DPS, but still the highest rogue by almost 100 DPS. And then we went into BWL with no world buffs left, and we went to BWL, and I actually again was the number one DPS overall throughout the entire raid. And don't get me wrong, I do have pretty decent alternative gear outside of the Claw of the Black Drake, so that's not fully holding me back, but a lot of the mains in this raid have Biss gear, Biss weapons, almost full Biss gear. I am not the most geared person in my raid by any means, and so this just goes to show, for the most part, that your playstyle and how you play, if you play smart, utilize your CDs best and your uptime, you can actually do better than other people with significantly better gear than you, just if you're more attentive. Now, again, I do want to mention that this isn't something negative towards any other rogues in my raid. They are all extremely good players, and the numbers of 540 DPS there with me being on the top isn't something extremely impressive either. It was, again, a very scuffed raid a little bit, so we should increase that DPS by at least 200 coming with Darkmoon Fair and a full main raid. Moving on, I just want to look at some of the fights throughout the raid. And this is one of those fights where I still don't have Adrenaline Rush up. I actually used Blade Flurry and Jamgabar earlier, so I don't have either of those, and I'm currently using a single trinket. So this is a good example of pretty much if all of these bosses were to be spread out. I'm not getting off any cleave damage. I will use Blade Flurry here, but the boss is already at 1%, so I'm actually not really going to get any cleave damage in this fight for the most part. I also do have Thistle Tea, but I don't have Adrenaline Rush. Potentially it'll come up at the end, but that's just a little sketchy. So currently I'm at 1.2k DPS. 1.2k DPS is something that's actually very good without Darkmoon Fair, and that's using the Claw as your main hand. So it's pretty easy to do a lot of DPS without even having all of your CDs. Even without getting cleave, 1000 DPS, we end there with 1k DPS, so there's no real excuse to say that this is a bad weapon or that you can't do as much damage as other people who have better weapons, because again, there are people in this raid with full Biss gear, full Biss weapons, rank 14 weapons, and we are seeing that the Claw can do really well because 1000 DPS on a non-cleave fight is pretty good. So this Silithid royalty fight was actually a 99. 11% of my DPS was cleave, and in a good one of these fights, you're gonna have 30 to 40% of your DPS be cleave, and I didn't have my huge cooldown like Adrenaline Rush. So it's actually not that hard to do very well, again, with the Claw of the Black Drake, even if you have a little bit of a scuffed fight. You can get 99s with this weapon. But what about some of the other fights? Now, I'm skipping forward to Fancris because I want to show you another fight where I don't have full CDs. So this is another fight where I don't actually have Thistle Tea or Adrenaline Rush. They were both used on Sartura, so I don't have full CDs. I get my Slice and Ice up, I do have Jamgabar, and I don't use Double Trinket, which this is a fight I would actually suggest in the length of the fight we have, using Double Trinket. But without Adrenaline Rush or Thistle Tea, which are your two biggest DPS abilities, especially for a single target and for cleave, of course, I'm still holding out at about 1000 DPS. So you can see that with Darkmoon Fair and with Adrenaline Rush, this could easily be 1.4 to 1.6k DPS. with the Claw of the Black Drake. Now, of course, the AQ weapons are pretty much leagues and bounds ahead of everything else in the game. If you are struggling with weapons in this game, I fully encourage you to test out different items. Again, I will leave that weapon spreadsheet in the description right below, but you can't really let these things hold you back. So to answer the question we asked ourselves at the beginning of the video, is the Claw of the Black Drake any good? And can it hold up to all of the other really incredible weapons in the game? And the answer is yes, it is a good weapon. No, it is not as good as using a CTS or an AQR. No, it is not as good as using a Pugio or a Death Sting, but it is a very viable weapon. So that's pretty much it from our first video of meme weapons, starting with the Claw of the Black Drake. Of course, guys, as always, my name is Sarth. If you liked the video, make sure to like and subscribe. Feel free to leave something in the comment if you want to see me use any other weapon combinations. And also, if you want to come hang out with me or see me do all of these things live, you can, of course, check me out on Twitch, twitch.tv/Sarth, every Monday through Friday. Sometimes Saturdays, just check the Discord because that's when I post if I'm going to go live on Saturday if I'm in town. Thanks for watching, guys. Peace out. Good luck out there. And don't feel so bad about your meme weapons.